to come closer to killing Hitler than any assassin before him. George Elser was a cabinet maker with strong socialist beliefs. He had spent a year single-handedly building a bomb to kill the Führer. Like Bavo, Elser saw Hitler's annual commemoration of the Beer Hall Putsch as his best opportunity. Elser moved to Munich and visited the Bürgerbräu Beer Hall night after night, even hiding there after it closed. He dug a secret hole in the pillar behind the speaker's rostrum. In it, he placed a time bomb he'd built himself. Expecting Hitler to still be talking at 9:20 p.m., Elser set the timer on his bomb for that exact time. The 8th of November arrived, and everything began according to plan. At the last moment, however, Hitler finished his speech early and left unexpectedly. Some 20 minutes later, the bomb exploded, killing 9 people and injuring 60. Hitler almost certainly would have been killed by the explosion. He visited the wounded in hospital, his amazing survival only confirming his belief that fate was on his side. Hitler took the assassination attempt very seriously and milked it for propaganda. The bodies of the dead were put on public display and crowds of Germans paid their respects. Hitler consoled the bereaved families. On the night of the explosion, Elser was arrested as he crossed into Switzerland. Under interrogation by the Gestapo, he admitted to the assassination attempt and even reconstructed the bomb for them. Elser was imprisoned in Dachau concentration camp. He survived most of the war before being executed in April 1945. German newspapers claimed that the British Secret Intelligence Service had been directly involved in the Elser plot. In retaliation, Nazi intelligence set up a snatch operation at the Dutch border crossing near Venlo. German agents, pretending to be Allied sympathizers, convinced 2 British agents that they could introduce them to a German general organizing a plot against Hitler. On the border, the 2 British agents, Major Richard Stevens and Captain Sigismund Payne Best, were thrown into a car and taken to Germany. The Venlo incident made the British deeply suspicious of those Germans claiming to oppose Hitler. The Führer seemed too popular in Germany for any assassination attempt to be carried out easily. As the war entered its second year, opposition to Hitler within the army was maintained by a small, close-knit group of officers. Former Army Chief of Staff Ludwig Beck formed a group known as the Black Orchestra. Along with retired Field Marshal Erwin von Witzleben, General Henning von Treschow, Count von Heldorf, head of the Berlin Police Force, and Ulrich von Hassel, former German ambassador to Rome. Another group comprising civilians and army officers was led by statesman Helmut von Moltke. Because they met on the Moltke family estate at Kreisau, they were known as the Kreisau Circle. Yet despite these 2 groups, opposition within Germany was muted. 1940 was the year of Hitler's greatest military successes. In a rapid blitzkrieg campaign, he had conquered the Netherlands, Belgium, and France. These dazzling victories silenced the objections of many opponents, especially those within the army. It seemed that Hitler could do no wrong. But then, he made his greatest mistake. One that was to galvanize his opponents into the most serious attempt on his life. June 1941, Operation Barbarossa. Hitler launched the greatest ground offensive in history against Russia. Joseph Stalin's Soviet Union crumbled before him. Hitler considered himself a god of war, able to achieve victory anywhere. Why should anyone want to kill him? However, by the end of 1942, the Germans had ground to a halt at Stalingrad. The great Soviet counter-offensive began. German military support for Hitler began to waver, encouraging conspirators who'd lain dormant during his years of success. In February 1943, one group of German officers planned to arrest or kill the Führer during a visit to their HQ on the Eastern Front. But at the last moment, he changed his flight and the plot was abandoned. A month later, near Smolensk, two British clam explosives were disguised as bottles of brandy and handed to a member of Hitler's personal staff, who carried them onto Hitler's plane. The aircraft took off with the Führer and the bombs on board, destined for East Prussia. The bombs were timed to explode half an hour into the flight. 2 hours later, the plotters heard that Hitler had landed safely. An officer was immediately sent to retrieve the bombs before they could be discovered. It's probable that the low temperature in the storage bay of the plane prevented the detonator from igniting the plastic explosive. 2 weeks later, Hitler's miraculous luck was tested again by Colonel Rudolf von Gersdorf, another member of the growing number of military dissenters. Von Gersdorf joined Hitler at an exhibition at the Berlin Museum. In the pockets of his greatcoat, he'd placed two bombs. He searched for Hitler, prepared to blow himself up alongside the Führer. But Hitler passed too quickly through the exhibition, and von Gersdorf had to run to the nearest lavatory to remove the fuse just in time. Whilst German opponents of Hitler were planning their assassination attempts, Allied organizations